CNBC-TV18 Weekender.
Let's talk about the finances as well. I mean, as you were telling me that each one of your restaurant is something that you yourself have funded.
Sure.
How have you worked your finances through the years then?
So I do save money from my restaurants. I don't have partners. I am a proprietor. Okay. I don't borrow money. I also believe in putting my mouth where my money is. That's very important. It's like a cookie cutter sort of thing, unfortunately. I don't save too much money for myself. Okay. But the thing is that whatever I invest in the business is made from the restaurants and re-put in the restaurants. I like to make sure that I don't use somebody else's money and blow it up. Today's times are very different with funding and private equity and stuff. I feel that it kills the purpose of business, of restaurants.
Where does that learning come from to you?
I think through experience, nothing else.
Farrokh, tell us, you also have served or catered to the Prime Minister.
How
was that experience? Your catering list actually has a lot of celebrities on.
We do. See, I'll tell you, celebrities come with the turf, honestly speaking. We do a lot of team weddings. We do weddings for corporates. We've done catering for the PM when he was CM, actually. For Adani, for Torrent Pharma, for people like that. And for special occasions, like we do a lot of catering for the RBI, for the Reserve Bank.
But another aspect of business, as you said, is catering, and that's how you started, really. All these theme destination weddings, parties, etc. How would you rate food there?
I feel that catering is one of the most challenging and one of the most appeasing business also. That it appeases you also. So imagine you're a client. You say, Farrokh, I want this. You create. Now it's my duty to create for you. And that's a great pleasure. Like, for example, I'll give you an example earlier. Say we did a wedding in Mombasa. So I asked the client, what do you want? He's saying, I want ostrich. Generally you don't cook ostrich, so you create it. They have a huge tree there called the Balbao tree, which has a pink fruit, which is this big. The lady of the house said, Farrokh, create. That's where the real challenge comes in.
So how many times has that happened, that you're given an ingredient and told to create?
Oh my God, that happens very, very often. Today, my only bane of running restaurants, is that if I could only be creative, I don't want to do management. Seriously, I have to do it. I have to do marketing. I have to give interviews. But I have to do it.
I hope you're enjoying this one,
enjoying
though. Let's also talk about more finances here. So tell me, you said that you were really blessed to have good landlords.
Sure.
How has that relationship worked? Because Mumbai, when it comes to homes, houses, rentals, is a very difficult place
to
be.
It is. But one thing I can advise people is, I think you must have your best relationship with your landlord, in terms of payments, etc. Feed him good meals, invite him very often.
That would come from you for sure.
And build personal relations with him.
On year-on-year basis, how have you seen the impact of GST, taxes, etc.?
As long as the mop-up of money that is collected is used for the right purpose, that's very, very important. The other thing is that I know it's a huge burden on the regular diner. For example, we used to serve a service charge, comma GST, which came to around 30%. I've knocked off 8 or 10% of my profit. And I pay my staff, the service charge. I read this morning this paper that a lot of nearly 90% of the restaurants have stopped serving service charges.
Service charges.
I just read this morning.
Yeah.
And I think it's only fair. And with only one gratification in place, that this mop-up of GST, brings down prices. That's the only thing that we can really, really hope for in the future. And I hope the government does it, and I hope the government works in that direction.
So tell us, when it comes to India, what do you think a person who steps out of the house to eat food is looking at? Is it food, ambience, price, flavor, service?
I think it's a combination of few. I'm a little unhappy with the way restaurants are going in the last 2-3 years or the last 4 years. They've become cheap booze drinking joints and they're full, And I think the essence of good food is being lost. Good ingredients is being lost. I think it should move back to that slowly, slowly. And more chefs. And, I think people are taking an easier shortcut out now these days, So I think if that moves, there'll be again... See, there was quite a renaissance time where Indian cooking was concerned. Not Indian cuisine,
sure,
but Indian chefs, I think that needs to come back. and really needs to come back, so that the diner has that thing that he doesn't go out just to dine. He goes out for an experience.
Well, on that note, we'll take a short break, but come back soon and have more interesting conversation with Farrokh Khambata.
CNBC-TV18 Weekender.